Now, a lot of times people will attack the clear rapture passage in Matthew 24 that tells us that the rapture comes after the tribulation. They'll try to attack it by saying, well, when the Bible talks about Jesus coming in the clouds and the trumpet sounding and him gathering together his elect, they'll say, well, the elect there, that's not believers. That's talking about the Jews. Now, first of all you have to do to figure out that that's false is to just look up every time the word elect is used in the Bible, and you'll see it's always talking about believers. And over again, he refers specifically to Gentiles, to the Thessalonians, to all manner of Gentiles as the elect. He tells us that there's neither Jew nor Gentile in Christ, and that we are the elect. And I would strongly encourage you, if you haven't done so, to look up every mention of the term elect, and you'll see it's talking about believers. But just to show you in this exact chapter how the elect cannot be referring to the Jews, if we just back up a few verses in Matthew 24 itself, it says in verse 24, "For there shall arise false Christs and false prophets, and shall show great signs and wonders, insomuch that if it were possible, they shall deceive the very elect." So the Bible talks about that in the end times there will be false prophets and false Christs that are going to be so convincing that if it were possible, they would even deceive the very elect. Meaning that it is not possible for the elect to be deceived by false Christs and false prophets. He said if it were possible, they would be deceived because these guys will be so slick, they'll be so convincing. But it's not possible. Well, ask yourself this question. If the elect is referring to the Jews in Matthew 24, are the Jews being deceived by false Christs and false prophets today? Absolutely. By and large, the Jews do not believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. The Bible says, "Who is a liar but he that denieth that Jesus is the Christ?" He is Antichrist that denieth the Father and the Son. And so therefore, those who deny that Jesus Christ is the Messiah, those who deny that Jesus is the Christ, the Bible says they are Antichrist. You see, in order to believe that Jesus is not the Christ, you have to believe that there is a Christ. The word Christ means Messiah. You have to believe that there is a Christ and that Christ is not Jesus. Well, who fits that bill? The Jews believe that the Messiah is still coming. They believe that Jesus is not the Christ. The Bible says, "Who is a liar but he that denieth that Jesus is the Christ?" He is Antichrist that denieth the Father and the Son. Therefore, these Jewish so-called rabbis who teach their people that Jesus is not the Messiah, that Jesus is not the Christ, the Bible says they are Antichrist. So when the Bible tells us here that the elect will not be deceived by false prophets and false Christs, that can't be talking about the Jews, because the Jews are the most deceived people on this earth when it comes to the Christ and a false Christ and a false gospel and a false prophet, because they believe that Jesus is not the Christ. They're being deceived by all kinds of rabbis and false teachers and their false religion of Judaism. But let's go with the normal biblical interpretation. Look at all the other mentions of elect. It's talking about believers. Now, does it make sense to say that believers will not be deceived by false Christs and false prophets? Of course, it makes perfect sense. Jesus said, "My sheep hear my voice. They will not follow another. A stranger will they flee from, for they know not the voice of strangers." The Bible tells us that the believer has the Holy Spirit living inside of him, which will guide him into all truth. Believers on the Lord Jesus Christ will not be deceived by the Antichrist. They will not be deceived by false Christs and false prophets. The Jews, on the other hand, are already very deceived.